And right away, LR back up by 21 points. And we'll see another drive start from the 40, another great drive for Wingate. And the first play, Vince kind of nowhere to go here.
Yeah, again, LR, tough run defense, one of the better run defenses in our conference.
Again, just trying to manage this drive, not try to get too much all day. You know, you don't see a lot of plays downfield, but that's just a credit to the offense saying, hey, we have plenty of weapons to get short gains and get enough for first downs.
Yeah, one thing about LR, they're very sound in what they do. They don't give up a lot. They don't make a lot of mistakes defensively, don't give up a lot of big plays. So we felt like we just want to keep chipping away and then take our shots when it was time.
Great catch by Bowden. We'll see this twice. It was actually on a third down and about 15 after a sack. And Halfley put it up there. And Chris, so much to do. Catch it, get your feet down, hold on to it, stay forward. I mean, so much to do on this play.
Again, another weapon in the receiving corps that we feel like we've got some guys there that can do some damage.
Another fun Vince Jordan run. Coach, how tired and hurt is Vince after the week? I mean, he just bouncing off defenders.
I tell you what, you wouldn't know it. He comes back to practice on, you know, beginning of the week and looks, you know, fresh as always and keeps going hard.
Here's another kind of play like the Ellington earlier, just a long catch, but then Floyd turns it into extra yard, just keeps turning those feet.
Basically the same pattern that we got an interference on earlier, and is able to turn it into a big game.
Two plays Cody probably wants back, the incompletion to Thomas and then batted down by Weber. But Coach, you bring on the field goal unit,
right?
It ended up being pretty much the difference, and RP just absolutely drilled that field goal.
Sure, and he did a nice job, came on there. Really, I was looking to get him experience. I didn't know if I'd be lying to you if I told you points would be crucial in the game. Wanted to get him we hadn't kicked a field goal in a while, put him on the field. It at least gets us points out of the drive. I felt like if we didn't get any points there, that would have hurt us, definitely.
So here's a first down on the next drive for Lenoir-Rhyne. We'll see first down here again. Again, a great push from the left side.
Yep, absolutely.
It seemed like the right side was where they had been successful during the afternoon, and here they'll go to the right side again, and a big hit comes in. I believe it was Phillips, Fletcher in there as well, Stevens, but somehow the ball pops up and a present for John McKinney.
Absolutely, absolutely. We busted on him about not getting in the end zone here, to say the least. But again, just the momentum here, you can kind of feel it. We kicked the field goal, seemed like something small at the time, but now we get it back. Nelson Woods punches it in here. Just a real good sequence of plays. And then we follow up with a two-point conversion, and all of a sudden, I think you can start to feel something here like, okay, this is maybe there's a swing going on here, and that definitely was a good feeling.
Nice play here for Halfley, reaching across. So LR gets the lead, back to 17. Kicking off here in the fourth quarter, and Perry Floyd, maybe the biggest play, just he needed instant points of the second half. And,
absolutely.
And Floyd looked like he was stopped right around the 30, and all of a sudden he just squirts out of the defense, and it's lights out down the sideline, even though he made it interesting the last 15 yards.
He was laughing
about that after the game.
He really, I wasn't sure if he was going to get in. I couldn't tell whether they marked him in from my vantage point or not. I saw him rumbling, bumbling, stumbling, getting down there, and it was just a great run. But here, you take it when you see this on film, you see their outside guy comes clean, gets a good shot on him, but he kind of gets bounced off another one of their guys here, kind of right there. Everybody kind of collides, and I don't think they realize he wasn't down. Pops out of there, and he's got such great speed. You know, Perry just a tremendous side, 2-time male athlete of the year in his high school, just making plays all over.
He literally stumbles for 17 yards and somehow sitting on his feet, a little freeze frame there, and you think he doesn't want it. So again, the defense needs another big play.
Absolutely.
And they get it. And a huge play for field position. This drive will end on a fumble. But you just seem like LR just wanted to run out some clock and then punt it down inside the 10. But a huge fumble coming up. And again, I'm sure because Richie got some hype for not picking it up and trying to run it in.
And he did. As you know, Coach James does a great job with those guys about scooping, scoring, score on defense, all that stuff. So definitely some heat this week from him about just not scooping it up and scoring.
You were joking around. Four white jerseys around the play. It's one or the other.
Yeah, absolutely. Could have, you know. But again, the same thing. Momentum wise, now we, you know, things just keeps, you know, ball keeps rolling our way, bouncing our way. We may not be playing great, but it is bouncing our way at this point.
So here's a 3rd and 10. Plenty of time for Halfley, and he finds Ellington, a huge completion. Just a great job offensive line. Halfley just stepped up and just stood on the line of scrimmage and waited and waited and finally found Ellington.
Absolutely. Great play. Again, like you mentioned, offensive line, giving great protection. Cody just able to look at the field, see the whole field, and our receivers able to continue to make something happen.
Holding penalty puts it back to the 43, but just 10 extra yards for Halfley to Floyd, who the LR looked like they're trying to make a sandwich out of Floyd, and look who emerged from the pack, the 5'8" Perry.
Kind of funny, because same thing that happened on the kickoff. He gets whacked from both sides here, and one guy hits him from one side, one from the other, keeps him up. So, again, the same route, going back to the same thing that we had hit him twice on earlier. We felt like we had success with it. Perry runs it really well and obviously able to make a play there.
So it's now back on the defense. Well, first we'll see the two-point conversion that fell a little bit short. Looked like a pretty good play. Ellington just couldn't roll over. Good job of tackling over there on the outside.
Yeah, they did a nice job. You know, he's going lateral here when he catches it. Would have liked to have seen him just lower his shoulder and get over there. But it's tough because he is running lateral. So nice play by LR.
So LR gets a first down. Now we'll see first, second, and third here twice. But, Coach, offense said, hey, put the ball back in the defense court. Defense gets a turnover and puts it right back. So it's a fun back and forth, the offense and defense trying to outdo each other and win the game.
Absolutely. And I, at this point now we're so close. We have not had the ball at all during the game since early where we actually have a chance to go up. So at this point, this was such a huge stop where if we get the ball back, regardless of what happens, we have the ball in our hands with the chance to win the game. And it's a one possession game at that point.
So we'll see. I believe it's third down here. And again, that's all you ever want as an offense, correct? And a coach, just a chance.
Absolutely.
And boy, did the Bulldogs take care of that opportunity. So here's third down once again. And you can just see the defense just dying for a stop.
Absolutely. And I think that they just know, just selling out for the stop there. Great job by the defensive line up front, to say the least.
So Wingate will get the ball back on their own 9-yard line. 91 yards to go. No field goal is going to help. About 3 minutes and 45 seconds. There's obviously a big huddle with the offense. What did you say? How excited were the guys? What were the looks on their face?
The looks on their faces were just as they'd been the whole game. You know, just very calm, very, all right, let's go. Let's get this done. That was the thing that, again, impressed me the whole game with them, in that there was just never any panic. There was just kind of, here's where we go. We're just going to execute our offense. You know, Bob Brown gets them on the sideline in the huddle. And it's just more execution things. All right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to, first down, second down, third down. We're thinking this. We still have a lot of time, but we want to be in two-minute mode. We want to get up the field as quickly as we can. And we were able to execute that. And I tell you, just very calm, very confident group in there.
Coach, you're a former offensive lineman. What does it say about the offensive line? You know, they've been out there most of the game. They're big guys. They're tired. And really, I don't think Cody really had any pressure on them. The couple balls he threw away just because there was nobody open. It wasn't that he was real pressured. It just seemed like if anybody dug deep that last drive, it was the O-line, because Halfley had all day.
Yeah, you're right in that credit to Mike Long, the offensive line coach, offensive coordinator, and a credit to those guys in that they're in good condition. They're able to go the whole game, a game where we a lot of points on the board, and in the final drive be fresh enough to protect Cody very well enough for a game-winning drive. So absolutely.